Hey, what's going on? My name is Matthew Connolly. Welcome to my channel. If this is your first time here, I upload music video editing tutorials in Adobe After Effects and Premiere Pro. I also upload behind the scenes of my music video shoots and just give you guys more of an insight of my creative process with music video creation. So for today's video, I'm going to be teaching you guys how to do this cool green screen effect where you pretty much take a green screen clip of your subject and you pretty much multiply them and add a bunch of them within the same scene. Let's hop into the computer and get started with today's video. All right, so now we have Adobe Premiere Pro opened up. The first thing that you wanna do is drag your clip into the timeline. And once you have your clip dragged into the timeline, we're gonna search up the effect Ultra Key. So this effect is pretty much just gonna remove the background from your subject. So just drag that onto the clip and then go over to the effects controls, and we're just going to be playing with the color. So we're going to click on the key color and try to just find a color that matches the background that we're going to be removing. So for me, I'm going to do like a darker green. Next, we're going to go over to the matte generation and we're just going to adjust the shadow and some of the tolerance. Okay, it's just pretty much just adjusting all of these values until you completely keyed out the background, which just means remove the background. Right, so now let's go to matte cleanup. Let's add some contrast. Let's play with the midpoint a little bit. All right, that's looking pretty good. So let's see, it looks like it fully got removed. Okay, cool. So now we're just gonna, you know, quickly color correct the image a little bit just so we can see it properly. I'm just doing a really quick job right here. All right, that's good for right now. So now we have the key. Now we have the clip keyed out, and we also have it color corrected. All right, so the next thing that we're gonna do is we're gonna duplicate this layer. So click the layer, press Alt or Option, and click and drag up to duplicate to the next layer. Now we're gonna play with the positioning. So go over to your effects controls and just drag this over a little bit, and you'll see that now we have multiple of the subjects. And let's do that again. So we'll do 3 in the front, we'll do 4 in the middle, and then we'll probably do like another like 2 or 3 in the very far back. Let's actually adjust some of these real quick. So just drag this down a little bit. For me, I'm using a medium shot. You know, your clip might be a little bit different, but I'm just gonna drag it down a little bit just so we can kind of hide more of his waist, and gives us more room to add more layers behind him. So we'll just reduplicate all of these, send this one up. Okay, let's duplicate it again. Drag that all the way to the left. You kind of get the idea, right? Then we'll play it through. Now we have 3 of the subject. Cool. You can play with like the ordering of it. You can make like the one in the middle kind of be in front of the other two, or you can like stack them however you like. So let's just drag all these guys up now. We're gonna create some more video layers. So just highlight all of this, press Shift and just drag up just so we can get some more video layers underneath, because then we're gonna start adding more layers underneath these initial 3 that we just created. So let's just take the bottom one, press Alt on your keyboard and drag down to duplicate it. So now we have another duplication of that, and we're just gonna play with the scale. So maybe like bring the scale up to like 1/12 or so, or we don't even necessarily have to do it that much. Just do it like 107, and then kind of just play with the positioning of that. Maybe 105. Just play with the positioning. Let's duplicate another one. Drag that one again. Duplicate another one. Drag that again. Let's duplicate another one. Drag that again. Or if you want them all to be the same size, you can too. I just scaled it up a little bit. Let's keep going. So now we're gonna add another row, right? So for this, we're gonna duplicate it again. And let's play with the positioning even more. You can drag it up, because now it's kind of gonna be hided by the middle row. So you don't really see the bottom of where his like torso is being actually cut off from the green screen clip. So we're just gonna, you know, keep filling this in. For this, we'll probably just do like three. So just do like three right there. Let's do like one more. You just play around with it. I'm kind of just showing you guys like the basics of how to remove the background and just add multiple of the same subject. It's just tweaking everything until you get kind of like the aesthetic that you're going for. And then if you wanted to kind of sell the effect a little bit more, you can add like a blur. So what I did was, in the example, I added a Gaussian blur, I believe, or was it a camera blur? Oh, I added a camera blur to the, pretty much create separation and more depth within the scene, right? So if we go over here and we start adding some camera blurs to like the really far back ones, it's gonna make it look like they're further away from the camera, which would be realistic in the sense that, you know, generally the further away you are from the subject, like the background ones should be in, out of focus compared to the ones in the front. By adding the blur, we kind of just draw the viewer's attention to, you know, one of the guys, so they're not overwhelmed as much with, you know, like 12 dudes. They're kind of just like focused on one or maybe a couple. Let's keep adding some blurs to these, just to kind of sell the effect a little bit more. Yeah, so I mean, like, I'm just doing camera blur, like 2%. You can crank it up even more if you want, but that's up to you. So I'm just gonna keep the one on the middle, the only one that's not blurred out, just so it kind of adds more of like draws your attention a little bit more to it. And then we can go in and add like a background behind them if we wanted. Oh, also, if there's any like pixelation in like the shadows when you're like keying, you can just go and just keep adjusting kind of the settings until that gets removed. I just did a really quick job, so. All right, let's just add the clouds behind them. If you want the clouds to be moving faster, let's just speed it up. Let's just do like 2,000. Or let's do like 1,000. There you go. And let's just render this through just so we can watch the playback smoothly. But yeah, this is pretty much the basics for this effect. You know, you can add effects on top of all these green screen people if you want them to glow. You can add like glows onto it. If you want to add more people, you can add more people. You get the idea though. But yeah, if you learned something new in today's tutorial, give the video a thumbs up and drop a comment below with what you learned. Turn on post notifications and be sure to subscribe to the channel. And I hope I see you guys next time. Peace.